Good morning, Wolverines. I'm Cabo.
And I'm Daisy. Welcome back to the first Wakeup Woodside of 2024.
We're starting off with Finish the Lyric with Cherie and Kyla.
Hey, Woodside. I'm Ariana.
And Control the Sound Golden.
And it's 2024, and we're your new host for Finish the Lyric.
NBA Youngboy Edition.
What are you doing?
Control the Sound Golden.
Y'all can go. Alright, I don't know what that was, but that was a little weird.
Kind of a mess, but it's okay, we back.
Yeah, we're back. New year, same host, and we're back to Finish the Lyric, but this time we have a different edition, and it's called Nostalgia Edition. What are the rules?
Well, you either have to finish the rest of the theme, or you can guess what show it's from.
Alright, I'm excited for this one.
You ready to see how many of y'all can remember?
You ready?
Yeah.
Hey, look up Woodside, and you're here with
Kyla
and Khalil. Now, this is the host of the show, but I'm just here taking over. Now, what are we doing today?
You have to guess the song lyric. Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Okay, let's play it.
Amazing World of Gumball, automatically.
Dun 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 dun.
Oh, we're down here. All right, so I'm here with
Carmen.
You ready?
Yeah.
All right. Neither, you don't know. It's from iCarly. It's the theme song from iCarly.
I don't watch iCarly.
That was a great show, y'all. That was a great show.
No, all right, so I'm here with Darnell. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You gonna get it right?
Yeah, I'm gonna get it right. You see?
All right.
Living Maddie.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be hard. I thought you was about to play, like, some dog with a blog or something.
All right, that's it for this week, Woodside.
All right, we'll see y'all next week. I hope you guys enjoyed this first package of 2024.
Daisy, they really got to start putting some real songs on there.
Yeah, like Don Toliver.
No.
Anyways, here's Miles and Zara with Learn the TikTok.
Take little steps while circling around each other.
One partner points while the other swipes their chest.
One partner act like they have low health and the other repeats.
One partner gets revived and then the other.
Step and swing down.
Buckle up.
Both partner cross their arms and hit their thighs. Then shimmy your shoulders and hit your thigh again.
Then cross your arms up and under. Kick your leg out, do the twist, and lastly, do the jig.
Isn't it like law?
Law and order.
Yeah. Thanks for tuning in, Wolverines. I hope you enjoyed this week's segment.
Now on to the next one. Next week.
Sir, are you gonna learn the TikTok?
No, I know that. No one paid attention to that. But you better pay attention to this next one because it's important.
Here's Jerry with mental health.
What's going on, Woodside? Welcome back from your breaks and holidays, but now it's time to come back. Yeah, I know, I know, I know. But in today's package, I wanted to go over mental health and why it's important going into 2024. So let's get straight into it. Well, what is mental health? Well, mental health is a state of our emotional and social well-being. It affects how we think, feel, and act. Well, why is mental health important? Keeping a good mental health can make you feel better about yourself, as well as increasing productivity. Having a bad mental health can lead to drug abuse and social isolation. Some ways you can maintain good mental health is by keeping a balanced diet, regularly exercising, and staying connected to your peers. Some ways you can show support for people battling mental health is by donating to mental health organizations such as Active Minds and Mental Health America. Another way you can show support is by wearing clothing that supports it. I'll put some brands on the screen that you can buy from to support mental health. But that's all for this segment, Woodside. Be sure to be mindful of mental health going into 2024 because it's going to be very important. Make sure you check on your peers and constantly remind them that everything is okay and they have help if they need it. Have a great week and be safe. Do the right thing. Don't make no bad choices.
And that's why mental health matters.
Daisy, you know, this is kind of random, but I think that Attack of the Clones is the best prequel movie.
What?
Doesn't matter. Anyway, here's Ariane Key with Unpopular Opinions.
And on this episode, we'll be asking Wolverines their unpopular opinions this 2023. I'm here with...
Zimmer Page.
CJ.
And what was your unpopular opinion this 2023?
My unpopular opinion was that...
Cinnamon Toast Crunch and Rod Wave are overrated.
Why Rod Wave?
Bro, because he sounds the same in all his songs.
That Travis Scott had the best album of the year.
When an NBA young boy, like, I mean, like, is he good or like?
He all right, I guess.
He's not the best, at, like, in 2023.
No.
I'm sorry, I forgot. Give me my key. Huh? Drake had album of the year. Stamp. Not Travis. Not Doja Cat, none of them. Drake had album of the year. Facts.
What was your unpopular opinion this?
Brent Faiyaz, Bryson Tiller, and Chris Brown are all mid, and YoungBoy is better than all of them. I'm so serious.
Anyways, my unpopular opinion is that Panda Dunks weren't even that bad. Y'all just ruined it. For me and for everybody else.
That's all we got for you this week. What's up?
We'll see you on the next one.
What's your unpopular opinion, Daisy?
My unpopular opinion is that Pink Tape is the best album.
Anyway, here's Start Bench Cut.
With us.
What's up, Woodside? I'm Cabo.
And I'm Daisy.
And today, we're gonna be starting, benching, and cutting movies that came out in 2023. What's your favorite movie that came out last year?
I'm gonna say Across the Spider-Verse, because it was such a good movie. And did you listen to the soundtrack? It was amazing. Everything about it was a 10 out of 10.
This is Brock. Brock, I need you to start, bench, and cut these three movies from 2023. First up, we got Barbie, we got Across the Spider-Verse, and we got Game of Thrones. That's not what it is. New Hunger Games movie.
Probably have to start with Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. It was pretty good. I like the story, the music, always top tier with those movies. I'd have to bench... The Hunger Games, it was a good story. It stuck to the book. There were a few misconceptions in between directing and the cast, but never watched Barbie. I watched Oppenheimer instead. It's way better. I have no opinion.
Thank you.
I'm here with Josiah. Out of these three movies, which one would you start, bench, cut? Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, The Hunger Games, and Barbie.
I'm probably going to start Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Although there was a... It was like a plot twist. It's still a good movie. I'm probably gonna bench The Hunger Games. It's a good movie. I like the books. And then I'm probably gonna cut. I don't like it.
All right, that's valid. Thank you.
Thank you for watching. We'll see you next week.
Huh? Oh, thank you for watching. See you next week.
That's what I said.
Oh, really?
Okay, bye. Hi, Woodside. That wraps up this edition of Wake Up Woodside.
Again, we're your hosts, Daisy.
And Cabo. And we'll see y'all next week.